So I'm on my Ubuntu machine. And right now, if I open the terminal and look for the version of Node that I currently have, we can see that Node was not found. And that's because I don't have Node installed on my computer. So let's go ahead and install it. Now, you might be tempted to run apt install Node.js, as we are suggested over here. But the thing is that that's probably not the best option. And the reason is that you're going to be stuck with the version that's in the Ubuntu repositories. Now, as we'll see in a second, the version in the Ubuntu repositories can be quite far away from the latest version of Node. And you probably don't want to be stuck behind. So I recommend that you don't install it from the repositories, and I even recommend that you uninstall it if you already did. To uninstall it, you can use the purge command. Now, I don't have anything installed, so it won't uninstall anything, but it won't hurt to run this command anyway. Great, so now we have a blank slate, and we can go ahead and install the latest version of Node. One option to do that is download it directly from the Node.js website. So let's head over to nodejs.org, and here we can download the latest version of Node. As you can see, two versions are suggested here. One is the LTS version, which is a long-term support version, and we also have the latest version overall. Now, I want to show you which version we would get if we would download it from the Ubuntu repositories. And to check it, we can use apt cache. And as you can see, in the Ubuntu repositories, the version is 20.22, which is very far from the latest version that we can download from the website. So I'll go with the LTS version, so let's just click on it to download it. And it's been downloaded. Okay, the file was downloaded. Let's get back to the terminal. And let's change to the downloads folder, which is the folder to which the file was downloaded. And here we can see the file we just downloaded, and we can see that it's a tar archive. To extract this archive, we're going to use the tar command. And if we list the contents of the downloads folder now, we can see that it was extracted to its own folder. So let's move this Node folder out of the downloads folder to the home folder. And here we are. And here is the content of this folder. Now, as you can see, inside this folder, there is a bin folder. And here, we have everything we need, which is basically Node and NPM. If we look for the version of Node now, we can see that it's version 16.14, which is the same version that we saw on the website. So we now have Node. But the problem is that it's only accessible from this specific directory. What we need to do is make it accessible from anywhere on our system. To do that, we're going to add this folder to the path. So let's get back to the home folder. And we're going to edit the bashrc file. And let's scroll to the very bottom of the file. To add a new folder to the system's path, we're going to use the export command. And we want to take the current content of the path. And then we want to append to it the bin folder of our node folder. To append to the path, I'm going to use colon. And let's open this folder in the file manager just to make sure that we get it right and don't have any typos. And here's the bin folder. And let's paste it to our path. Let's save the file with Ctrl S and exit with Ctrl X. And let's close this terminal. And if we open the terminal now and try to access Node right from here, we can see that we have it installed and we can access it from anywhere in our system.